Dynamite download.
You know, talking about telling a story, Taz comes out at the beginning of the show, and in a way that very few men can on television, he has a way of drawing in the audience and getting him to see whether you agree with him or not, whether you might think that he's a little bit bitter or biased or what have you. The man brings logic, and sometimes the truth hurts. And he's pointing out, he's throwing these daggers, man. He's pointing out how Ricky Starks and Brian Cage have continued to be overlooked. And I love this new side of Team Taz. I don't know about you, but I love their attitude. They're just going after it and taking it and making an impact and refusing to be ignored.
Yeah, I completely agree. And I think it was an outstanding way to start the show. And I am excited to see more of Team Taz. And he makes some very good points. And it's being backed up, you know, week after week. Ricky Starks is awesome on the mic. I mean, overall, that Team Taz should be unstoppable. And the way to start the show, I mean, Taz could suck the air out of the crowd for everyone to listen and then just build it back up full of emotion. And he is just an A-plus at that. And, I mean, transitioning into the match with Brian Cage and Matt Sydal, that was an excellent opener. That was a very good opener. You know, there was some very – it was fun to watch. I don't think Matt Sydal is a lower card wrestler at all. You know, unfortunately, he's lost twice on Dynamite, but I think he's got some really good potential. I see some excellent moves in the ring. He's got some good charisma. Some of the key moments was when he did that diving double knee onto the
on-ramp. Phenomenal.
My knees started tingling just watching that.
Yeah.
And Sydal is so fun to watch. And the finisher with the drill claw out of midair, it's a perfect finisher just to show how strong Brian Cage is. And we know he's strong. And it was just an outstanding finisher, very well-fought match, very high energy. And I was happy to see, you know, Cage back into the ring and on Dynamite because, you know, we've kind of been a little hard on him because, you know, he started off kind of with strong and then fizzled out. And then maybe, you know, we weren't too big of Cage fans. But I think this is kind of reestablishing him as a true badass. And being with Team Taz is an outstanding pairing and adding Ricky
Starks.
It certainly
helped him. Absolutely. Yeah. Is this an elite or a delete out of you? It sounds like it was an elite, right?
Yeah, this match and overall, including the segment, if I just had to grade the match, it would definitely be an elite.
Yeah.
And the overall segment is a double elite too, both before, during, and after. So it's like a triple elite.
I don't even have that many hands. That's phenomenal. I love that. No, you know, that's one of the things I continue to appreciate more and more. This trio that they've put together between Taz, Ricky Starks, and Brian Cage, they complement each other so well. I really have become more and more impressed by the way that they play off of each other. And I think that it's a great teamwork in the sense that they all complement each other in a way. Obviously, I feel like Ricky Starks is a lot more confident and comfortable on the mic than Brian Cage is.
Yeah, for sure.
And that's okay because Brian Cage, there are very few men on earth that are big and strong and fast and powerful as he is. So
true.
He doesn't need to have to always talk. He has other guys that can do that for him. And I love what Taz brings. Not only does he bring the legacy of his career in the ring and outside the ring, the guy, he has had successful podcasts. He's been great on radio performances, great ringside commentator. I always love when Taz is on commentary. I know you and I
me
both
too.
Agree. He brings a different analysis, a different viewpoint to wrestling that is oftentimes overlooked. So I think that all three of those guys really, really work together. And right. I love seeing them on screen. I love the quick strike offense of a Ricky Starks and the impact nature of Brian Cage. You don't need to see them on TV a whole bunch
right.
in order for them to really make an impact. Ricky Starks can hit one spear or have a couple of cheap kicks, and Brian Cage hit one clothesline, and you're feeling the pain because those guys know what they're doing. They bring it quick. So I thought that was really great. One of the things I'm going to comment on, too, about the match itself, you know, a couple weeks ago, Matt Sydal went up against Eddie Kingston before Full Gear. It was actually last week's Dynamite.
Right.
And I was actually a little torn about that match because I was thinking, man, Kingston struggling to put away Matt Sydal right before the, you know, his I Quit match. And right. I was a little, I think I was looking at it kind of negatively. And I definitely was looking at it more through a prism of Eddie Kingston's character. The more we see Matt Sydal on television, the more obvious it is that he's really talented. And
I agree. Maybe
we forgot about how good he was. He looks like he's in the best shape of his life. He certainly is somebody who can keep up with anybody. The pace of his matches are always entertaining. I think for a casual fan, if you flip on and you see Matt Sydal, you want to see him more. His offense is just that. It's fast. It has that snap, that pop. He executes things, you know, obviously, his debut in AEW aside, he executes things with some precision and some finesse that you can't get anywhere else. So I've been really impressed by him. I think that the Brian Cage match tonight, again, was a great pairing, David and Goliath. Anytime you put Cage in a match with somebody like a Matt Sydal, like a Rey Fénix, you put him in the ring with guys, even a Trent, you put him in the ring with guys like that who have the work rate, who can go and maybe allow him to give those big, powerful strings of offense, but a lot of work around a guy like Cage. I think that this was a great example of what Sydal can bring to the ring, and I certainly would like to see more of him going forward. I think this was no doubt an elite from me as well. The whole segment, I continue to be impressed by Team Taz. Cage needed to be reestablished on national television legitimate contender. And now we see where he's going, right? And I think it's a great fit for him going into that program with Cody, going after the TNT title. Obviously, we know that Ricky Starks might have his eyes on that prize too.
Right.
But I think that is the right match for Brian Cage. I don't necessarily think that he's ready for the world title at this stage. I think that big picture, you have him going to a feud for the TNT title. You have him and Cody. You have Ricky. You have that Darby Allin and Ricky Starks. Obviously, we're playing off the long history between Team Taz and Darby.
All right.
It's a win-win. They're really doing a nice job. Like we talked about, SPD, just blending all these characters together, allowing it to breathe, giving some long-term storytelling.